Okay, on this next video, I want to show you how to add up your sheets into maybe a sheet that would contain your totals. So maybe your sheets are different months or different years, and a lot of times you want to add those together. So notice down here I have a sheet for 2010, 2011, and 2012. Notice how they're also in the same format. If you're going to use the tool that I'm about to show you, it's fairly important that they have the same column headings and the same row headings. It just works out the best when that is the case. So let's say I want to add these sheets together and get a total. So I'm going to go over to sheet 3, and actually let me rename that. I'm just going to right click on the sheet, and then actually this sheet has a chart in there, so let me pick on sheet 4. I'm going to right click on sheet 4 and then rename that to be our totals. Okay, I'm going to go back to one of my other sheets, and the data here starts in cell A3. So let me go to my total sheet, and I'm also going to start in A3. This feature is called consolidation. The whole purpose of consolidation is to add different sheets to each other. So I want to pick on data, consolidation. Now, first of all, you can make it a sum or a count or a product. So you have all these different calculations. Of course, to add things together, we're going to do a sum. Then here's what you do. You're going to pick on reference. Pick on the first sheet. And I'm going to highlight from A3, let's say down to H10. That range could be as big as you want it to. But I'm starting at A3 there because this way I can include the row headings and also the column headings. And then we're going to pick on the word add here. And notice how that range is within this section over here. Then I'm going to pick on sheet 2011. And notice how it assumes that you want to use that same range. That's why it would be important for you to have the sheets in a pretty similar format. And we're going to add that. And we'll pick on sheet 2012. Notice how it's using the same range. And then we'll add that. So you want to add all your different sheets, as many as you want it to. Now look what it says over here. Use labels. So if you think about our data, the first row does have labels, and the left column does have labels. So you want to check both of those. Now here's a nice choice. It says create links to source data. So what that means is, if it is going to add those ranges together, but if any of those numbers change in the original sheets, it'll also update the total. So I'm going to click on OK. And now we have some numbers here. So I assume that these are the numbers that are added together from the different sheets. So let's see if that's the case. Let me expand this a little bit. All right, so the sales for January says 16,500. So let's go back to 2010. 2010 had 6,500, and 2011 had 4,000, so that's 10,500. And then if we go to 2012, that has 6,000 again. So that's going to be 16,500. When we go to the totals, we have 16,500. Now let's go to the computer section. The computer section in 2010 has 14. In 2011, it had 7, so that's 21. In 2012, we had 9, and we add those together, and that's going to be 30. Now let me show you something. We said we wanted to do a link there. So I'm going to go over to sheet 2010. And let's say in the computer department, this one is going to be 18,500. Before it was 14, now that's going to be 18,500. So that should add $4,500 to the total in the total sheet. Let's see if that's the case. It should be 34,500. And you can see that's what happened. So that's what that link was all about. When we change one of the totals in the sheets, it'll redo the totals over here. Now notice these plus signs over here. These plus signs will allow you to expand and then see the actual details. So then you have an idea of the details there. But if you notice, what we really have is a sheet that added up the other sheets together. And the way we did that was data, and then consolidate. And then you pick your ranges. You would make sure you pick a sum or any of the other calculations. And then if the top row does contain your field names, you want to click on that. If the left column has your labels, you want to click on that. And then we made a link as well. And that is how we do consolidation or adding your sheets together here in Microsoft Excel.